Good morning, good noon, good afternoon, good evening. Kung sa diin ka man nga parte sa kalibutan, dako ang akon nga kalipay nga makapakigupod naman kita sa isa ka isa pagi sa sininga panimbahon. And today is a very special Sunday because we are celebrating our back to school Sunday. Kag sa sininga adlaw, ang aton pagatunan nanungod sa teaching ministry ni Kristo Jesus. And ano abayhan ang iyang reminder sa aton yung mga teachers, sa aton yung mga students, sa aton yung mga parents, kag sa aton yung tanan sa sining nga pagsugod sa sining bago nga school year. So let me entitle my sermon for today as Let Us Not Stop Learning. Now let me read Mark chapter 1 verses 21 to 22. Nagasiling, they went to Capernaum, and when the Sabbath came, Jesus went into the synagogue and began to teach. The people were amazed at his teaching, because he taught them as one who had authority, not as the teachers of the law. Amo ini ang pulong aton pamalandungan sa sininga aga. Now, sa sininga aton nga pagpamalandong, we ask ourselves, ano bala ang ginhambal sa balaan nga kasulatan para sa aton nga tanan sa pag-remind sa aton sa mga lessons nga aton ipasulod sa aton nga mga paminsaron, ipasulod sa aton nga mga tagipusoon as we start this new school year. Now, first and foremost, let us not stop teaching the lessons found in the Bible. Mga kuturan, hindi kita maguntat sa pagdala sa mensahe sa balaan nga kasulatan. Madamo kita nga lessons nga matunan. That is why every day, ako ni na nga commitment to write something, malipot nga seeds of faith every day, kagang ako nira nga ginabutang lessons nga aton matunan. So lessons for today, lessons that we can learn from a specific Bible verse. Sa aton nga madumduman sa aton pagbasa sa Gospels, Jesus was called a rabbi. And meaning, sa isang rabbi, isa siya ka-teacher. Now, matahong nga si Jesus Christ nagtudlo sa aton sa nga iyang pagpanudlo kung sa diin siya blang lugar. Now, in this instance of the Bible verse that we have read, Jesus was in a synagogue. But you know what, my friends? Jesus did not limit his teaching ministry in the synagogue. Sa iyang time, ang synagogue amoy na ang classroom nga area. Pero wala gin limit ni Jesus ang iyang teachings dito sa sulod sa synagogue. Nagtudlo siya beside the lake, in the middle of the sea, no? In the mountains, in the streets, in homes, in the temple courts, in the field, and many more. Kadamo sa mga avenues, kadamo sa mga areas nga si Jesus dito nang plastar kag nagsugod sang iyang pagpanudlo. Now we can just imagine dito siya sa mountain top, no? Ang nagatudlo kag amoy ni ang Sermon of the Mount. So this means nga kita mga kuturan, natudluan kita sa sining ehemplo ni Kristo Jesus that we have to teach everyone, including the next generation of Christians, sang mga values, sang mga lessons nga ara makita sa balaan niya kasulatan wherever we are. So hindi limited sa isa ka area, sa isa ka geographical area ang aton nga pagpanudlo, kundi kung sa diin kita nga lugar, basta may teachable moment, dira kita magatudlo sang kamaturan nga aton natunan halin sa balaan niya kasulatan. Now, Jesus also taught using different means. Sari-sari man yung pamaagi ang pagpanudlo ni Jesus Christ. And he mainly used parables. So, kung ninyo man notice, ang Gospels is full of parables, mga stories. Ang meaning ng parable is an earthly story with a heavenly meaning. So, katahum sang iya ni Jesus Christ nga pag-illustrate sang many stories through the parables, kagdra niya gina-explain ang mga theological thoughts niya. Dra niya gina-plastar kung ano ang mga theological principles behind those things. But Jesus also did not limit his teachings on parables. Nagamit man siya sang similes, sang hyperbole, sang illustration, sang comparison, sang logic, and many more. Nagdebate man siya gani. So, sari-sari ang pamaagi ni Jesus Christ sa pag-reach out sa mga tao sa iyang teaching ministry. And that means for all of us, we need to vary our way of teaching others So sari-sari man dapat ang aton papanudlo sa mga katawhan. We have to find a way to reach out to people. So kung anuman nga means of communication, kaganuman nga way to communicate to people ang aton gamiton, hindi kita malimit sa isa lang kabagay. So kung dira kaya komportable sa sininga bagay nga magpanudlo, then go for it. Kung dira kaya komportable sa sininga bagay nga magpanudlo, then go for it. So kabay pa nga sa sininga aga, ma-remind kita sa iyang implasta ni Jesus Christ that the lessons of the Bible need to be taught anytime and anywhere. Now, let us remember also that one of the objectives of Jesus in his teaching ministry is to point out the errors and to correct it. Amo ini actually ang legacy sang education. Amo ini gali ang objective sa isa ka teaching ministry to teach what is right and to point out what is wrong. So amo ini ginobran ni Jesus Christ kag amo ini remind sa aton what can we learn from this? Number one lesson, we need to be brave enough to point out mistakes in our society and make steps to correct it. Baka budlay ini mga kultura niya klase isang principle nga gintudlo ni Kristo Jesus sa aton. There are many glaring errors in our community but we oftentimes choose to ignore it. Kadamo sang ginapiyungan na lang sa aton nga mata, kadamo nga ginapalipas naton nga mga sala. Some are probably afraid of pointing out errors and some are just plain apathetic. Duwala na kita paki sa nagakalatabo sa aton palibot. Ang iba niya nakulbaan man. Kaya kung mag-point out ka sang error, basi akigan, ikaw, o kung worst, may threat sa imong kabuhi. Now, Jesus actively pointed out errors that were perpetuated by religious leaders. Kung ninyo nakita kagina sa aton versikulo ang ginbasa, gin-compare sa nga manunulat ni Mark, si Jesus, kag ang mga leaders of the law sa ilang teaching ministry. Now we can remember the answer of Jesus when he was asked by a Samaritan woman regarding the proper place to worship God. It was a teachable moment for the Lord Jesus Christ. Kag wala iyang ipalampas ang ina nga kaintangan because he also used the question and answer method of teaching. So siling ni Jesus, sa ginpamangkot siya sa templo, gitbala akon sa mountain, ang nagkaigo nga dra magasimba. And Jesus answered, "The true worshipers worship God in spirit and in truth." So si Jesus nag-correct sang wrong notion of worship that God is limited to a particular place and in a particular time only. So gin-correct ina ni Jesus Christ, gin-isla niya ang punto nga gina-perpetuate sa mga tao, ang punto di vista nga sala katama, kay nga gin-limit nila nga ang Diyos makita lang sa templo, kag ang Diyos masimba lang sa natalanang ation. Siling ni Jesus Christ, anytime and anywhere, basta gina-worship mong Diyos in spirit and in truth. So talking to a Samaritan woman was also a form of correction. Grabe ini ka tabu ang inubra ni Jesus Christ. Grabe ini ka no-no ang inubra ni Jesus Christ because this was against the religious tradition during the time. Kay ang mga lalaki, nagapati sila nga ang teachings ang Diyos para lang sa ila. Kag ang mga lalaki, sila na lang yung mateach ang mga babae. But in this instance, gin-correct ni Jesus Christ nga pwede tudluan sa spiritual truth sa mga babae. Now, the second thing nga gin-correct pagin ni Jesus sa sininga pag-istorya niya sa Samaritan woman was that gin-correct niya ang notion, ang pagpati sa mga Hudiyo that the good news is just for the Jews, para lang sa mga Israelites. Hindi. Gin-correct ni Jesus Christ, that's why he talked to a Samaritan woman. So, hindi lang to babae nga against religious tradition, kundi Samaritan pagid nga against pagid sa mga Hudiyo. So, diring ipakita ni Jesus Christ nga ang gospel, ang mayang balita, ang principle nga ginadala sa aton is that we need to point out errors. Now, number two, nga iyan ni Jesus nga gintudlo sa aton is that we need to be humble enough to accept corrections. Mga kauturan, gabatsyag mamla kita kung may nag-correct sa aton, nag-grabbing aton reaction, o kung nag-pangaki kita dayon. Oftentimes, when we hear corrections, we react by getting angry. And then, we launch a counter-attack. Hamunin dayon ang ginabuhat sa ibang. Gina-attacki man din nilang tao. Nga, ikaw, wow, ang mukha man ini. So, hindi nga ginabinag-binag, kuntani, ang correction nga ginatag sa ato, and we humble ourselves to accept sa sila ang mga bagay nga ginahatag sa aton nga correction. Now, let us read Hebrews chapter 12, verse 11, kinagasiling, no discipline is enjoyable while it is happening. It's painful. But afterwards, there will be a peaceful harvest of right living for those who are trained in this way. Katahom sa ginambal sa writers ng Hebrews, nga kung may nagadisiplina sa aton, may nagakorek sa aton, may nagatudlo sa aton sa correction, kung batunon naton, biskan masakit ina, maabot ang tion nga insakto na ang aton pagpangabuhi, bangod nagbaton kita sa sina ng corrections. Yes, my friends, to accept corrections is painful. It will hurt your ego and your pride as well. Pero bilang mga Kristiyano makuturan, we need to admit our mistakes and make necessary actions to correct it. The consequence of accepting corrections is to harvest a righteous life. I-share ko bala sa inyo ang akong experience sa Our Daily Bread. Malapit na lang ang September, kag ang isa ka article nga gin-approve sa Daily Bread nakon nga i-publish, kag na-publish na no sa United States of America, kag nabasa na nila dito subong, pero magwain na siya officially sa website nila this coming September, and next year will be sa Philippine edition sa Our Daily Bread. But it took more than 2 years bangod dalas ang pandemic, pero usually ang ila ko no process is about a year. But you know what? Nag-agi ako sa pila ka mga editors. The first one would be the editor, the biblical editor. The second one is the theological editor. The third one is the historical editor. And the fourth one was the grammatical editor. So, apat ka editors ang inagyan sang 220 words sa isa ka article sa Our Daily Bread. So, i-appreciate mo na sa buong mga kuturan kung nagabasa sa Our Daily Bread kada adlaw, kag nagabakal ka sa booklet sa Our Daily Bread, i-appreciate mo ina. Kaya mo inang inagihan, gali isang tanan ng authors, dira apat ka-editors ang nag-edit sa isa ka-word nga nag-comprise lamang sa 220 words. And you have to accept the corrections. Amo ina, painful ka tama, pero ginatudluan ikaw kung ano ang insakto. So, kabay pa, nga sa sininga aga, ma-remind kita sina. Saul became Paul when he admitted his wrongdoings and accepted the corrections of God. And Paul was successful in his ministry because he was humble enough to be corrected. Grabe sigurong pag-bruise ang ego ni Paul, no? Amak mo religious leader ikaw, Pharisee of the Pharisees, sa imong thinking na balaan mo na ang tanan, pero ginbulag siya sang Dios, kag gintudluan siya sa mga disciples and other people nga gipadala sang Dios sa iya. So, and he was humble enough to accept those corrections. He was humble enough sa pag-change ang iya ways, sa pag-change ang iya mga perspectives kag theological insights. Yes, my friends, later Paul would instruct Timothy to use the scriptures for reproof, for correction, and for training in right living. Ginpasa man ni Paul ang iya natun-an sa next generation. Kabay pa mga kuturan that we should point out errors and accept corrections as well. Now let us go back to the main point. Secondly, let us live out the lessons that we have learned from the Bible. Kung kagina atong natun-an nga ang balaan niya kasulatan, hindi kita maguntat sa pagtudlo sa mga lessons from the Bible. Ikaduwa, sa sining aga sa atong pamalandong, kabay pa, nga hindi lang nga nagtuon kita sa mga lessons, but we live out the lessons that we have learned from the Bible. Ginasulit-sulit natin sa pagtuon ng Shema, the most important statement of faith for the Israelites, which can be found in Deuteronomy chapter 6, verses 4 to 5. Nagatudlo ang Shema that we must teach our children that there is only one God and that we must love Him with all our being. With all our being. Now, the command that Moses gave us is for us to teach the Shema while walking, while sitting, before going to bed, and when waking up. Now, siling pagid ni Moses, we also have to put up Bible verses in our homes to visually remind us of God's teachings. Wow! Ang initanan nga mga ginambal ni Paul sa pagsugo nga kampanying di Shema, nag-remind sa aton mga kuturan that for us to live out the teachings of God as found in the Bible. Hamak mo, itudlo mo ang balaan niya kasulatan while walking, while sitting, while before going to sleep, while nagbago ka bugtaw. Anong po silingon sina? Inibot silingon nga samtang nagatuon ka, gina-internalize ni mo, ka ginakabuhi ni mo. And you are showing exemplary living to people. You are living out the lessons that you have learned from the Bible. And because of that, you are a walking teacher. You are teaching by example. Katahom sila nga punto mga kuturan, nga kabay pa nga aton dumduman. Now, as we start another school year, let us once again commit to continue on learning lessons from the Bible and live it out in our lives. Sa Great Commission, aton gid nga madumduman, that we can see that Jesus said that Christians must teach the next generation of disciples to do what? To obey everything that Jesus has commanded the first batch of the disciples. No, ano ang principle nga ma-learn natin diri sa iya ni Jesus nga teaching ministry? Siling kagina sa ang atong ginbasa sa Mark, Jesus was someone who had authority. So ang iya nga teaching principle nga ginatudlo sa aton is this, a teaching them to obey principle. Teaching them to obey principle. There is a big difference between teaching what is right and wrong and teaching people not just to know, not just knowledge, but more importantly, to do what is right and shun what is wrong. Amo ini ang nagakadapat sa aton yung pagpanudlo. Let us check the perspective of our teachings. In the light sa ginhambal ni Jesus Christ, sa sininga principle nga teaching them to obey. Let us not just teach people the knowledge, but to empower people to do what they have learned. For example, diri sa Central Philippine University, gamiton ko ini nga perspective. Bangod ang mga American Baptist missionaries nagbilin gid sa mga core values, sa mga Christian core values diri sa CPU as a heritage. And later on, we put up the vision that says exemplary Christian education for life or excel. So, we do not just teach for the sake of teaching our students and making them achievers by their grades or scores, but we teach in order for them to be a Christian, to live the values that they have learned. Kagkabay pa nga ma-integrate nila ang ining mga values, ining Christian faith, into science, in kaga ang ining sensya it feeders, no? Science and faith, there is a CPU, gina-integrate yun ining duwa, may aras ang fusion, may aras ang integration. So, ginapakita nga aton gini-integrate ang Christian faith sa aton adlaw-adlaw ang pagpakabuhi sa aton nga teaching ministry. Now, over and above this teaching principle, Jesus is teaching us to obey what He commanded. Now, why can Jesus say this? Why can He command us to do what He said? Jesus can do so because He has all the authority in heaven and on earth. Kung may ara ka sa siling otoridad, siling sing basa natin kagina, then it simply means that Jesus is God. Jesus can command us to do these things, amo ining nasulit-sulit ko parmi, because He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Amo ini ang kinalain sang teaching sang iban sa teaching ni Jesus Christ. Because His teachings comes with the highest authority. Now, the next question would be, din nato makita, Pastor. So, kabay pa sa nagapamati isubong, we can find the specific commands of Jesus Christ in the Gospels. Kabay pa nga tunan natin ina, balik-balikan natin sa basa, pag natapos natin basa, basahon naman liwat. And in the light of the Gospels, we need to read the books in the Bible starting from Genesis up to Revelation using the Christian perspective in the light of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, in closing, let me share a very short outline of the word kinder. Si Nanay nag-introduce sa akin sa una sa isa ka libro by Robert Fulghum. Yang title sa sininga book is All I Really Need to Know I Learned in Kindergarten. Kag nasuggest ko sa inyo kung luyag niyong basahon ng inang libro, I highly recommend reading this book. It is a great book that you can learn a lot. But using sang outline ng word kinder, let me share to you a few things nga aton gid dapat dumdumon as we go through sa sining school year nga bag-o para sa aton itala. First, letter K, know that the Lord is God. Know that the Lord is God. Let us teach our children to know God and to be conscious that God is the owner of everything. Siling sang Psalms chapter 100 verse 3, know that the Lord, He is God. It is He who made us and not we ourselves. This means that we must be good stewards of God's creation. Letter I, sa word niya kinder, integrate science and faith. Now, siling na akong kagina, may ara sang principal sa Central Philippine University about science and faith. Now, here is an example nga makatudlo kita sa aton nga mga kabataan. We teach biology or the study of life and living organisms. But at the end of the day, the bottom line of teaching biology is teaching the students how great is our God and how beautiful is our world. Amo na ang pag-integrate. Letter N, never give up on your children. My friends, no matter how tired or distressed we are, giving up on our children is one of the worst things that we can do. If we give up on them, then it is like telling them that they had no worth or value. Kauturan ka ba'y pang hindi kita mag-give up sa itong mga kabataan? There are two things that we can learn from the father of the prodigal son. Anong iya ginobra? Pray for our children and continue on loving our children. Amoy ning iya ginobra, kagamoy ni ang aton masunod. Letter D on the word kinder, develop their character. There is one quotation that can remind us that molding the character of our children is very important. Let me read this. Watch your thoughts, they become words. Watch your words, they become actions. Watch your actions, they become habits. Watch your habits, they become character. They become your character. Watch your character, it becomes your destiny. Aton gini na dumtumon. Letter E from the word kinder, encourage your children to pursue their dreams. We must talk to our children about their dreams. We must take note and take appropriate actions so that our children can pursue their dreams. Ayhan sa ang una nga panahon ang paglakat sa bulan, tama kay imposible. Pero sa isa ka tawo nga ngalan niya, kaangay sa akong ngalan, si Neil Armstrong, ginurture ina sang iyang mga parents ang iyang handong. And he became an astronaut and the rest is history. Amoy na man sa aton tanan, kabay pang encourage nato na aton mga kabataan. Letter R, relate with your children. Relate with your children. So let us listen and pay attention to our children. Let us always find time for our children. Let us plan activities that we can have, that we can go and have fun together. Let us also remember that we are once children. We are kids. And let us have fun. Kabay pa nga aton inadumdumon nga mga parents sa pag-start sa sining bago nga school year. Kag sa aton pag-celebrate sa back to school sa sining atlo. Now, these things are the things that I have learned in kindergarten, siling ni Robert Fulghum. And let me end with this. Let me quote Robert Fulghum sa dusi kabagay nga ako nakita sa iya nga book. Siling ni Robert Fulghum, share everything. Play fair. Don't hit people. Put things back when you found them. Clean up your own mess. Don't take things that are not yours. Say you are sorry when you hurt somebody. Wash your hands before you eat. Remember to flush. Take a nap every afternoon. When you go out into the world, watch out for traffic, hold hands, and stick together. Be aware of wonder. Remember the little seed in the styrofoam cup. The roots go down and the plants goes up. And nobody really knows how or why. But we are all like that. Kabay pa sa sining nga bagong school year sa ato pagatubang mga kuturan, teachers, students, parents, all of us, let us not stop learning. Let it be that the church is the number one example of a learning community. And we must learn from the greatest teacher of all time, the Lord Jesus Christ. May God bless us all. Amen.